morning, men. My name is Gabby Velez of the Teaneck Youth Initiative, and today we are introducing a brand new segment we like to call Teaneck Rising Stars, where we highlight the young people in our community who are doing big things. Now, it may be an athlete, a performer, an artist, an activist, doesn't matter. We just want to highlight all the people in our town who are putting us on the map. Now, we're gonna get real. We're gonna have deep conversations. We're gonna get insightful. We're gonna try to make this as engaging as possible. And we just all hope that that you guys enjoy. So without further ado, let's introduce our first rising star. Now, if I didn't pick this person first, I think I'd be a little crazy. But look, 2020 was a crazy year for all of us. A lot of us went through very hard times. But out of 2020 rose a star we all knew, especially if you knew her, would take hold of the spotlight as soon as she was given a stage and a microphone. With her soulful voice and her infectious smile, Olivia Reyes of 1T9 not only captivated America with her voice, but she made all of us in town jump with Teaneck pride when we got to see her perform on season 19 of The Voice. She had the honor of working with the great John Legend, and now her blind audition video has over 1 million views on YouTube. Now, it was insane to learn about the ins and outs of the industry from Olivia, but I think the best part for me was learning about how this experience shaped her as a person, the things that it changed in her, and how now she feels like a completely new woman. So without further ado, let's meet Olivia.
Okay, so we pretty much know what you already did, but like, start at the beginning, like what, like, how long have you been singing for? Like, you know, what were your plans before this? And then we're like, what made you wanna?
Well, I've never, and I kind of said this, like just flat out on television. I was like, I never really sung.
I peeped that.
I never really have sung. I had never sung, like on big stages before. I mean, I've always loved doing it since I was a little girl. I would be in the back of my mom's car, like, singing. I didn't know what I was singing, but I was singing Spanish, English music, whatever. I would try to compare myself to like other singers and mimic them, and that's kind of how I taught myself.
No, and it was funny because like, because I mean, we knew each other before, and then like I feel like I mentioned it, like people talked about it, like, why don't you do this, like, why don't you, and you were like,
that was like, always my response. I was like, oh,
so, like,
I don't know,
what
maybe
made you this time, like, what made you, you were like,
so it all kind of started a few years ago. So I was a freshman at an all-girls school, and that's kind of where I met like my best friends. So with that, they were the ones that actually signed me up. Like, I didn't know that they signed me up. They signed me up. And they're like, we have a surprise for you. And they would never, they didn't tell me. Like, they just kept going on. Like, we have a surprise, we have a surprise. And finally, like, I found out. And I was like, wait. I was like, what? I didn't expect
like,
it. Like, why? They were like, well, like, you won this show. Like, not like, you won this. So now you can, like, why don't you do it? Like, why not? I drove out to Boston with my mom. And that was like, you know, they told me to just come out. So I'd skip the whole open call audition. And they were like, okay, sing, do your whole thing. And they were like, great, you're moving on. Lo and behold, everything closed down. Everything shut down. The world shut down. So I was kind of like, well, I don't know if they're even going to continue with the show. Like, we didn't know anything that was going on. So March 17th was when I got the call. And I got a random call. And I answered it. It was from Malibu. It was like, what's this? So I answered it because I always answer calls. And it was this British accent that I had, you know,
recognized
okay. from the interview process. And my heart, like, dropped. Like, keep in mind, like, I was chill on the phone, but I was screaming to everyone. I was like, shut up. Like, as my family was home, and I was like, shh. And, yeah, he ended up telling me, like, we want you to come out to L.A. And he told me, like, a bunch of stuff. I didn't hear a word he said. He was, like, telling me about all the next phases. And I was like,
sis, I'm literally going.
As long as you're telling me that I'm going,
yeah.
That's it. Yeah, it was just, like, the most rewarding phone call of my life, obviously.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah, no, it was awesome.
Okay, so, like, you're on the stage. About to send falling. Now, when I perform, I blank out. I don't know what I just said or whatever. So how was it like for you? Did you, like, take it in? Were you like, oh my God, there's John or whatever? Did you have your eye set on somebody? Like, what did that moment feel like?
So if you watched it, when I was talking to Carson Daly, they were like, okay, you're gonna talk to Carson and whatever. And there was a lot of like B-roll that you do before you go on stage. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna, you know, do the B-roll, and then they're gonna be like, cut, okay, I talked to Carson, that's great. And then they're gonna wait, and then they'll be like, you know, open the doors. No, that's not how it happened. No. I kind of got on stage, made my mark, and I started singing, and I blacked out.
Blacked out.
So I felt like the music was behind when I was singing, but I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna breathe. And I shut my eyes. I was like, that was the first thing I went to. And I open my eyes, and then I just see John Legend staring at me.
Oh my God. Yeah.
And the whole like hitting the button, like we don't hear that.
You don't hear that.
Yeah, no, that's like in post-production.
Fun fact.
That's in post-production. So I like, that doesn't exist. Another fun fact, they cut out a lot of the talking that we do with them. When it came down to when I had to pick, I was there for about 5 minutes staring at them. I didn't know
for
who to
real?
Pick. Maybe like three, like a but solid 3 minutes. But it feels like minute, it. But it, like... it was a solid like 3 minutes that I was just like, I don't know.
Where are you from?
My name is Olivia Reyes. I'm 19 years old and I'm from Teaneck, New Jersey.
Come on, Olivia. The time has come. Who do you choose as your female coach?
Literally the hardest decision I've ever had to make in my entire life. I think I'm gonna go.
Come on home.
I choose John.
Yeah! Like after that last performance, like, I guess, how'd you feel? I mean, obviously, it's not the best feeling ever, yeah. Obviously.
Yeah.
But it does make us grow and does make us be like, all right, well, cool, now I have something to work on. But is there something like what's your outlook on performing now? Like,
I love it. I really
like,
do.
You want to keep going?
I do. I gain so much confidence. Mm. So much confidence in myself. And that's a situation that I feel like can make or break people, because it's like, if you're not meant for a stage, you're not meant for a stage.
Yeah,
and
sure.
Trust me, I was not the most outgoing on stage. I was not, you know, there were other people that outshined me when it came to stage performance and stage presence. But the more I did it, because, you know, every day you're singing to someone, whether it be a vocal coach, whether it be, the coaches, or you know, your friends, to be like, okay, how does this sound?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Regardless of all of that, like, it's really about like, okay, I need to just trust myself. I need to do what I have to do.
Mm.
So for me, I just think, I don't know. I found like a deeper love for it. And if anything, it was the most validating thing I've ever done in my entire life. The most validating. Like, I felt so strong and powerful and confident. And I don't mean any of this in like a cocky or arrogant way. I think it's just like, when you find something that you're meant to do, like, it's very obvious.
Stay tuned for part two, where we learn how this experience and living in Teaneck shaped Olivia into the woman she is today on Rising Stars Get Real.
That does it for this episode of Teaneck Rising Stars. I hope you guys learned something new, learned something cool, learned something insightful about one of your peers in the community who's doing something amazing and who will continue to do something amazing. So, if you guys have anybody you want to nominate, Teaneck High School students, Teaneck High School alumni, I'm going to drop the link below here. Nominate somebody. I'll put it in the link in our bio. But that does it for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. And we'll see you next time. Tarot deep, I can't call it. The beats make me falling asleep. I keep falling, but never falling 6 feet deep. I'm out for presidents to represent me.